Gilbert Taverner is college chaplain at Simpson College in Indianola, Iowa. He spoke before the Iowa Sponsors of Future Teachers of America at the Iowa State Education Association State Convention earlier this month. And you started out with the group by making some comment about the name of their group, the Iowa Sponsors of Future Teachers of America.
Yes, I suggested that they would probably have to change the name, not to Future, because that all pupils, all students these days, kindergarten through graduate school, are co-teachers. So that the student sitting there may be teaching you, because he has experiences you don't have. You will be teaching him. And so there are no future teachers, there are only present teachers.
Now, is this part of what you are identifying as one of the characteristics of the new breed of students?
Yes. Students today, even young children, have such an opportunity to travel. They see television, they listen to radio. Multimedia is a part of our time. Therefore, the extension of the classroom, even quite formally, is going on where it did not go on previously. You left school, you went to do something else. Now you may watch a program. It may not be formally educational, but actually it is an extension of it. This adds not only dimensions of knowledge heretofore not known, but it means that a student will see a program, for example, on television that a teacher has missed. He needs to express this. Then the co-teaching goes on.
Now, I was just thinking in a sense that this can have some major importance in this family relationship and perhaps some of the dying customs of the conversation around the dinner table, because perhaps the youngsters are in the role that the adults were before in conveying the information.
Precisely. You used to be able to go home and give a chemical formula that your parents didn't know, and this bugged them, as they love to say. But now, there are so many areas of activity. A student recently told me he tried to discuss the moratorium around the table, and it was verboten, it was forbidden, because the parents were not interested in this particular area of education, which the student felt was an educational technique, and which the parents felt was political activity not to be discussed.
Now, are we going to see more of this direct involvement of the student in the social issues and concern and expression of this concern?
Well, yes, I think we're seeing more of it. It is not really new. Comenius in the 17th century said that the method of education he liked best was for teachers to teach less and learners to learn more. Well, actually, these centuries later, this is coming into its own. So I think we will see more of it. And particularly with the multimedia, the mobility of students, a tiny first grader argued with his teacher about glacial action. He had thrown snowballs on the glacier and the teacher had never been there. The first grader was correct and the teacher was incorrect. Now this is an isolated example, but it goes on.
Now what does this mean as far as our present educational system?
I think it means breaking down the rigidities of structure. It means that the totality of education, which I think is already going on, is included in the activity of the school board, so that it is understanding that once a classroom is completed, that the education experience is not completed. The extracurricular activities are integrated, evening classes, classes for adults. The totality, this isn't simply children and youth learning, it is the total society being involved in this. Educational television, team teaching, it's just huge and growing and really quite spontaneous.
This is going to make a major difference in the training of our teachers?
Very much so, very much so.
Are these changes being made in our higher institutions?
That's a very delicate question to ask somebody on a college faculty. Sometimes we wonder if they're being made. I think that the teachers' colleges, if that's rather an anachronism, but the courses and teachers' colleges in general are trying definitely to accommodate to this. It is such an explosive thing, and the techniques are so expensive. The hardware, the equipment is there, but it's very expensive that it's hard to catch up with. I think perhaps some of the most exciting teaching is going on in the high school level. This is not to deplore college teaching. If you have two good teachers in college, no student has to learn, you see. Whereas in high school, he needs to be perhaps motivated more than he does in college. And I've been quite thrilled with some of the team teaching, some of the work which has been going on, which has utilized multimedia, so that students, for example, can talk about films, Easy Rider or Midnight Cowboy or these kinds of things, and relate them in societal ways. And this is teaching, this is education, this is interaction.
Well, with this sort of interaction on real meaningful things in the life of the young person, then perhaps school will be meaningful enough that there is not the need to drop out on these number of years that we expect young people to stay into the educational system. Now, the prior generations did not have as part of their expectations.
Right. In fact, instead of dropping out, there probably in the, get out the crystal ball here, mm-hmm. there will probably be a great many more opportunities to vary your education so that you may do traveling in connection with, say, high school work, or as well as college work, where small children will be encouraged to go not simply to museums, but to go to businesses and to see this kind of thing. And the interaction with society will go on, so students will not feel the need to be dropping out to do something. They will be dropping in, and the flexibility of the program and the creativity of the program will be conducive. This is a prediction which I'm hoping will come true. I'm hoping it's true now in many places, and it is.
How can the general public, the regular citizen, assist in adding the, well, shall we say, curriculums and facilities so that the educational system can carry out some of the things that have to be done in response to the student?
Right. I think that one of the things is that the education needs to involve the general citizen in terms of his activity. When you get somebody who is going to an evening class, this person understands more about the school property and everything else. I think that a program of communication across the lines as to what the changing modes of education are, how education has changed, all the things that are going on in the convention of the Iowa State Teachers Association, these things need to be communicated, as you're trying to do, to a general public. Then the public will see that these are not frills, that these are any kinds of using a television in school is not a frill. Having a film or whatever the case may be is not an extracurricular activity. Mm-hmm. It's an integrated part. Then they will be willing to see this in its proper perspective. And most people are, once they have the opportunity to see this and experience it. The general public is not opposed to education by any means.
And sometimes misinterpretation of the forms.
Very much so. And students, whether they be in grammar school, high school, or college, often lead in this misinterpretation by not always understanding themselves that something has meaning beyond their own participation in it. School boards and school committees, boards of trustees, boards of regents, need very much to be involved in the total educational process. So school committees could well go back to school, you see? Go back to school for a while and really understand what's going on. Boards of regents could do this. Exciting. And we've been doing some of this and enjoying it immensely, and so do the people involved. It's great.
It's always been a sort of an old adage, I think, that if somebody's complaining a lot, put them on the committee that's working on it, so
yes.
Then they'll know what problems you're dealing with.
Yes. Particularly if it's a committee that will help him participate and interact in the problems. This doesn't always work, but it can work.
I wish we had time to pursue some of your thoughts about the morality of the students, because being chaplain, I suspect you have some comments to make about this, but that would take an entire
yes.
new interview.
May I put one statement
yes.
in, risky that it is for such a brief time? I am very much impressed with the standards of morality of our students in general. And I think that they are not always understood. There are changing forms, but I think they're a people of high integrity, and I think they have deep sense of right and wrong.
Thank you. Gilbert Tavener is college chaplain at Simpson College in Indianola, Iowa, and thank you very, very much.